If you have ever tried getting internet off-grid, you know it's a constant juggling act between power, signal, and portability. Well, the Starlink Mini solves the signal part, but for everything else, that's on you. So, I've been testing a bunch of accessories that actually make your Starlink Mini way more practical in the wild. Whether you're going camping, road tripping, or if you just need backup internet during an outage. Hi, my name is Jeremy, and these are my top 8 accessories that made my Starlink Mini go from just a gadget to something I really rely on off-grid. So, let's break it down. Now, the first question I always get asked is, how fast is the Starlink Mini? Well, let's find out. So, we're hitting about 180 megabits per second, and that's fast enough for you to binge on your Netflix, take work calls from the bush, or FaceTime with grandma so that she doesn't think that you've joined a cult. Now, right after that, people always ask me, how do you power your Starlink Mini off-grid? Well, the Starlink Mini uses 20 to 70 watt depending on how chatty the satellites are. And we power ours using three options. Behind me is our truck. We have an EnerDrive 200 amp hour battery inside with an inverter, so we can plug the Starlink Mini in using the AC plug. And that usually lasts us for at least 2 days. When I go for a hike, I'll take this Anchor 747 with me. This one has a 140 watt USB-C output, so it's great for powering your laptop, your iPad, and even your Starlink Mini. This one has an 88 watt hour capacity, so it will keep your Starlink Mini charged for at least 4 hours. Perfect for working in short bursts. If I'm camping overnight or if I want to charge other gears, I'll bring the Blue Eti EB70. It's a bit overkill, but when you're off-grid, the last thing you want is to be on your last battery. This thing has a 716 watt hour capacity, so it will get your Starlink Mini running for at least 20 hours straight. Now, don't make the rookie mistake of buying a giant battery and not be able to connect it to your Starlink Mini, like me. The Starlink Mini doesn't come with a portable friendly cable right out of the box. This is where you'll need this. This is a USB-C to a DC barrel connector, like this. This is what makes it possible for you to connect your power bank to your Starlink Mini. But be careful though, there are many cables out there and they all have different voltage ratings. Buying the wrong one would mean you would not be able to draw power from your power bank, or worse, it could damage your equipment. Now, I've linked the exact one in the video description below to save you from the guesswork. And if you're going to be running the Starlink Mini from your car, your van, or four-wheel drive, you might want to grab one of these. This is a cigarette lighter socket to a DC barrel connector, and this will keep your Starlink Mini powered from your car. Now, some people ask me, how do you carry all this gear when you go hiking? Well, this is where I have one of these. This is a Stargear travel case. And inside, you fit your Starlink Mini. It fits in there nice and snug, and underneath it, you can fit your batteries. Here I have two Anchor 737s. And this thing is made out of ballistic material. It's very nice. And it is water resistant. The best part about it is that you can leave your Starlink on while you go hiking. And because you have the two Anchor 737s in there, you're basically good for at least 8 hours of internet usage. And it comes with straps, which makes this the perfect hiking companion. Once this travel case is set up, you can just leave it online, take it with you anywhere without even unpacking. It is seriously very convenient. Well, unless if you want something more permanent. Mounting solutions. This is where you can get really desperate or you can get really creative. We've got these two mounting solutions here. Let's talk about the mobility mount first. Now, with this mobility mount, you'll be able to mount your Starlink anywhere, provided you're willing to drill some holes. In our case, we're attaching it to our roof racks using a couple of T-bolts and nuts. And then we'll clip on the Starlink Mini. And it's got these two locking anti-theft screws built in, so once it's screwed in place, people won't be able to walk off with your Starlink. If you're going to be drilling holes to mount your Starlink, or if you have a roof rack, this is a great permanent solution. Now, if you do not have a roof rack, you might want to get one of these. This is a magnetic mount. Your Starlink goes in here, and these are magnets for legs. So it's as easy as clipping them on. With 33 kilos of magnetic grip, even on bumpy corrugated road like this, the mount is not easily shaken loose. Once it's on, it's staying on. If you're going to be leaving your precious Starlink outside your vehicle, I think it'd be a great idea to get one of these. This is a silicone case bumper. It goes in like this. And then it comes with a paint protection sticker that sticks all over the Starlink. And then it should be able to protect your Starlink from dust, rocks and chips, and even perhaps bird poo. So here's the bottom line. The Starlink Mini is incredible tech, but right out of the box, it is a bit bare bones. It's kind of like a phone without a charger. And these accessories don't just make it easier, they make it more usable. We've left the links for the accessories in the video description below. And if you're going to order yourself a new Starlink Mini, you might want to use our referral link so you can score yourself a 1 month free subscription. Thank you for watching. If you have a different Starlink setup, we want to hear from you. And if you've got questions, please leave them down below. See you in the next one. Bye.